Alfred Hitchcock once said of films that creation is based on an exact science of audience reactions. Many years after that shower scene, audience reactions are becoming an exact science. Neuroscientists are looking at how we watch movies to figure out which styles of filmmaking have maximum control over viewers' brains. It's popularly being called neurocinema. In one study, participants watched 30 minutes of The Good, the Bad and the Ugly in an fMRI machine, so their brain activity was being recorded. The researchers compared the pattern of activity in the participants' brains and found it was remarkably similar. During particular scenes of the movie, activity in certain brain areas increased and decreased at the same time across the participants, and their eyes tracked the same areas of the screen. The researchers suggested it was an indication those scenes were more engaging. A follow-up study compared the participants' brain activity watching The Good, the Bad and the Ugly to watching other things, like an episode of Alfred Hitchcock Presents, an episode of Curb Your Enthusiasm, and a real-life 10-minute unedited shot of a New York City park. The researchers again used the similarity of the participants' brain activity as a measure of how engaging the scenes were. They found the Hitchcock episode evoked similar brain activity across all viewers in over 65% of the cortex, the outer layer of the brain. Similar activity was seen in 45% of the cortex for The Good, the Bad and the Ugly, but only 18% for Curb Your Enthusiasm and 5% for the real-life New York City park. The study shows that Hitchcock could orchestrate the responses of different brain regions in a timely fashion across all viewers. Of course, fMRI can't evaluate the artistic and aesthetic value of a movie. And some movies and TV shows aim to control the audience's reaction more than others. It depends on the director's style and intentions. But soon we could see the audience sitting in the director's seat. It's been suggested films of the future will be so interactive that they will respond to your brain activity while you're watching them, so they can be the most engaging. It's like the ultimate choose-your-own-adventure that could end up being the true definition of a horror film. Neurocinema can objectively measure some of the entertainment value and audience reaction to movies, TV shows, and advertisements, and we can use the results to refine how engaging and emotionally effective they are. But it can't tell us who will walk away with this year's Oscars. Although big data can. Check out Forward Thinking to find out how something as seemingly unpredictable as an Oscar can be forecast using the right methodology. There's a whole new meaning to lights, camera, action. Let me know what you think and your Oscar picks in the comments. And if you don't already, subscribe to Braincraft for a new brainy episode every Thursday.